Iyak ang China kay Pangulong Bongbong Marcos. Chinese Major General sinupalpal ni PBBM. Inakusahan kasi nito ang Pilipinas na hindi daw sumusunod sa sinumpaang kapayapaan ng ASEAN at China. Sobrang agresibo daw ng Pilipinas. At nag-iimbita pa ng major power para gumawa daw ng gulo. Hindi rin raw nakikipag-usap ang Pilipinas sa China. Parang ang gusto raw ni PBBM ay war, not for world peace. Nagpantig talaga ang tenga ni PBBM nang marinig yan. Sino ba ang nambubuli sa South China Sea? At papaanong hindi magiging agresibong palaban ang Pilipinas? Niyuyurakan kaya ng mga Chinese kaming mga Pilipino? Hindi daw maisip ni Pangulong Marcos na sa lahat ng pambubuli ng China, tayo pa ang sisisihin nila.
Mr. President, I noticed in your speech you mentioned many times. In my words, to put it simply, we can summarize it as three no's. No intervention, and no use of force, and no hyping up hot spots. Only because of these principles strictly followed by ASEAN members, some of your Philippines behavior in recent times, it now sounds like you really consider other parties' comfort level, and there is a risk of ruining the regional long-earned, long-lasting peace since the end of the, colonialist history. What's your comments on that? Thank you.
I cannot imagine what you must be referring to if the reference or the allusion is to the Philippines somehow tearing apart what we have agreed on in the situation is a great deal more complicated than it used to be before. I would even go far as to say there is no such thing as a regional issue any longer. We have all experienced the unexpected effects of the war in Ukraine, of the conflict in the Middle East, and all of these. And when we talk about the South China Sea, we have to also remember that the South China Sea is the passageway for half of the world trade, and therefore the peace and stability of the South China Sea and the freedom of navigation of the South China Sea is a world issue. And that is what I am proposing. And I am saying that this is a regional issue, but we must examine and be part of the discussion. We must include all parties in that discussion, because now it is not just ASEAN member states who are stakeholders. And it is quite easy to see that it is in fact the entire world that have become stakeholders in the peace and stability of our region.